this tutorial, you'll learn how to use the new Intellitracker AI tracker in DaVinci Resolve Studio 19. I'll show you its advantages and why you should use it. Let's get started. I'll teach you how to use Intellitracker in the Color, Fusion, and Fairlight modules to explore its various features and everything it offers. All right, we'll start with the Color module. In this example, we can clearly see that there are many changes in lighting. Look at this skateboard. There are moments when it's well lit and others when it's completely in shadow. The lighting is constantly changing. In situations where the element we want to track experiences lighting changes during the video, it's advisable to use Intellitrack. To use Intellitrack from the Color module, we'll head to the Tracker menu, where we have three tracking modes: Mask Tracking, Stabilization, and for Effects. We can use Intellitrack in all three tracking modes. In this example, we'll use the FX mode. We go to the bottom, and in the drop-down menu, we click on Intellitrack. Once Intellitrack is selected, on the left side, we can add a set point. Upon adding a set point, this cross will appear in the center of our viewer. We need to place the cross over the element we wish to track. In this case, we'll locate it on this person's skateboard. To start tracking, we click on the icon with the two arrows. We can see how Intellitrack performs perfect tracking throughout the entire video, regardless of changes in lighting, different shadows, lights, and movements. Intellitrack has done perfect tracking. Now, let's do the same with the old tracking. Will it be able to track as well? We're going to delete the tracking we did with Intellitrack by pressing the Clear All Tracking button. To show you another mode of tracking, this time we'll add a circular mask and we'll locate it over the person's foot just as we did with Intellitrack. This time, as we want the mask to follow the movement of the person, we'll select the Mask Tracking mode. Perfect. Now we're going to compare the Intellitrack mode with the Cloud Tracker, to see if the Cloud Tracker can follow the movement just as well as Intellitrack. Perform the tracking. And as we see, it has failed in the middle of the clip. If we take a closer look, the tracking is quite good. But right in this part, a change in lighting causes it to fail. And in this other example, we have the same problem due to changes in the shadows and the brightness of the person's beanie. If we use the classic tracker, in a few seconds, it loses tracking and stops following the person. However, if we place the cross on the person and use Intellitrack, we observe that unlike the previous example, we achieve perfect tracking. For this reason, it's especially advisable to use the new Intellitrack tracker in situations where lighting is variable. In scenes with more stable lighting, all trackers tend to perform well. Once the tracking with the mask is done, we could already change the color of the person's beanie, reduce the brightness, the saturation, or make any other modification. We have now learned how to use Intellitrack in the Color module and what its advantages are over other trackers. Now, for the next example, which is the one here, we will head to the Fusion module. In this case, we're going to perform the tracking with Intellitrack and place a text over this person who's running. However, at one point in the video, the person passes behind a column, and since they're not visible, the classic tracking would likely fail. But what about Intellitrack? Let's see if we can track the person well with Intellitrack. To open the tool search, we will press the keyboard shortcut Shift Space. Here, we have to look for the Tracker tool, which contains Intellitrack. We add the tracker effect. Now the Intellitrack tracker will appear in the viewer. In the Inspector menu, we can see that indeed we have one Intellitrack tracker active. We will locate the Intellitrack tracking area over the person's head, and with this button with an arrow pointing to the left, we can do all the tracking to the left. And with this other button, tracking to the right. This depends on which frame of the video we are located. Notice how Intellitrack is performing excellent tracking. And when it passes by the column, it continues tracking without any issues. This is something that could have failed with classic tracking, Perfect. We have finished the tracking. Now, to be able to add text on top of the person, we must change the tracking operation mode to match move mode. To add a text, click on this icon here. And now, we simply need to connect the text directly to the Tracker 1 node, where we conducted the tracking with Intellitrack. Let's review the result. Notice how it perfectly follows the person, even when they pass behind the column. In this case, the tracking has worked well, but that doesn't guarantee that it will always be the case. Obstacles passing in front often cause quite a few problems. Lastly, we're going to use Intellitrack from the Fairlight page. That's right, we can also use Intellitrack for sound effects. If you're watching this tutorial on a mobile device, the effect might not be as noticeable. I recommend watching it on a computer with speakers or with headphones. In this case, we're going to track the sound that this helicopter should have through the space in which it will move, creating a much more immersive sound through spatial localization of the sound and panning. For example, if the helicopter moves to the right, the sound will come from the right. If the helicopter approaches, the sound will be louder. This is perfect for sound editing, for stereo systems, 5.1 sound, Dolby Atmos, etc. For this example, the first thing we're going to do is use this button on the viewer to display the tracking tools. Once these tracking tools are activated, the next thing we need to do is select the clip in which we want to track the sound and set an entry and exit point. We can do this quickly by pressing the X key, being on top of the clip. Once the entry and exit points are established, we will select the target track, and in this selector, we will use the option for left to right panning. Once selected, we will enable the automatic option. Keep in mind that in the automatic option, we still don't have front and back tracking. That is, movement along the Z axis. Therefore, we will enable the option for left to right and top to bottom tracking. Now we will place the Intellitrack directly on the helicopter. And to perform the sound tracking, we press the tracking button. Perfect, it's finished. Here we can see the tracking graph that it has generated in waveform form. But for you to see it better, we will activate 3D panning option. Notice that when playing the video, this blue circle will move through the 3D space in the same way as the helicopter. Let's see how the helicopter sounds and how the sound moves from one side to the other thanks to the tracking we just did. Now we have a much more realistic and professional sound, ready to add to our editing. Remember, you also have access to a complete course with over 60 videos to learn DaVinci Resolve, and free. See you in the next video.